Hey, this is Max here, and in this video I want to share one of my favorite marketing automation tools with you. So it's called Integromat. It's a little bit similar to Zapier in case you know that one. And they basically call themselves the glue of the internet because you can connect almost any tool you can come up with each other. So it's really cool stuff. So let's just dive right in. Then I want to show you what it's all about, how you can create a scenario, they call it. And then I want to show you some cool use cases. So this is Integromat, and as you can see on their homepage, they call themselves the glue of the internet. And I really have to agree with this because I could connect so many tools with each other that did not have a native integration with each other. But Integromat is really the glue and brings them together and unlocks really a world of possibilities. Now, if we scroll down here, then you can also see an example of an automation. They call this a scenario, and each scenario consists of a few modules. So you see, for example, here that we have a Gmail module. So this one is watching for new emails. So as soon as you get a new email inside your Gmail inbox, this scenario will start. Now then here you see, okay, it's going to add something to a row. Then it's going to iterate or get the attachments from that email. Then we have a router, which is basically like splitting our little scenario. So if there are images, then it's going to create a post based on the images inside that email. And down here, if it's a document, then we're going to archive those documents. And then we upload them to a Dropbox folder. So that's pretty cool, right? I will also show you in a bit exactly how you can create something like this. And then if we scroll down here, you see that it really integrates with hundreds of apps and services. And I think this is really cool, because when I started using Integromat, I think maybe about 2 years ago, then there were not so many integrations yet. But now slowly they're really getting more and more integrations, and almost every big app is in here. You can, for example, here see ActiveCampaign, you see here Asana, Aviber, or however you pronounce that, Blogger, Bitly. Here, what else can we find? Calendly is really handy. I'm using it myself. Also, I'll show you an example of that in a bit. Here, Clubhouse, Cloudflare. Now, basically everything you would ever want is in here. And if it's not in here, then you can either request that they make this integration, or you can just use, it's called a HTTPS module, and then you can make the integration yourself, basically. So let's just log in, and then I can show you some examples of what I'm doing, and I can also show you how you could actually create such a scenario. And then over here, you see that this is the dashboard. So as you can see here, I'm using the basic subscription plan. And this plan costs $9. It's really dirt cheap. Before, I was using Zapier and I was paying like 50 to 70 bucks a month for it. I switched to Integromat and now it's like really, really affordable. They even have a free plan, and then you can do 1,000 operations. You can transfer 100 megabytes of data, and you can set a maximum interval of 15 minutes apart. So it's pretty cool. I will also, by the way, put a link for Integromat in the description below. So if you use that link, I get a little kickback from that. But if you want, you can just use the free plan, then it doesn't cost you anything at all. But so yeah, this is the dashboard. And then, for example, now you see here that I use 35% of my operations and I use 3% of my data transfer. Then you also have a cool graph in here that you can see how much you are consuming, let's say. So that's pretty cool. And then scenarios. So here you see that all the scenarios that I created. So really, I am experimenting a lot with this. I absolutely love it. It's saving me, I don't know, I would say hundreds of hours per month, but it's a bit much, but like really lots of hours, and I can do things with it that otherwise would never have been possible. So let's just create a new scenario. I will show you how you can do that. And after that, I want to show you some of my favorites. So we're going to create it. Then I will ask, what services do you want to integrate? So you can just search for whatever you want to integrate. So here, for example, type Calendly, Google Drive, Twilio, for example, Facebook. You can do it like that, but usually I have to say I don't really bother with that. I just click here, skip, and then you get a blank scenario, and then just in here, you can still add whatever you want to. So for example, I could here say, okay, Gmail, and then it's okay, watch emails. So we want our scenario to trigger whenever we have new emails. So then over here, I say, okay, my connection is my email address over here. Then the folder, I wanna select my inbox. So we say inbox. Then filter type, simple filter criteria. I only want unread emails. And then we say maximum number of results. Now let's set this to 10, for example. And then we click OK. And then I can say, okay, from now on. And then I click OK. And then every 15 minutes, the scenario is going to check if there are any new emails that match that criteria. So as you can see here, this clock is this little schedule. You also have some other scenarios or some other modules that are instant. And then the scenario will instantly start whenever we trigger what is in that first module. So for example, with a webhook, something like that. But I leave this to this. Then we can click over here, add another module. And then, for example, we could send an email back to that person automatically. So we could say here, okay, send an email back to, and then we click in this field. And then you see over here that we get Gmail, module one, Gmail. Here you see module one, this is module two. And then we can say, okay, from who did we get this email? Here, sender, sender name, sender email address. So I want to send an email back to this email address. Then I say, okay. And then the subject is going to be whatever you want, or you can just say like this, RE, like a regular response, right? And then we can grab the subject. And then here we could, for example, say, hey, you could either say sender name, or you can just say something like, hey, if you don't know, want to use this. And then we could just say, I received your email and we'll try to get back to you after the weekend. Something like this, right? So then this email will be sent back. But so I said here, after the weekend. So I only want this email to send when it's currently weekend here. So that's on a Saturday or a Sunday. So to do that, you can add a filter in between your modules. And I think this is super handy. So what I could do here, I could just click this line and then it's weekend. So that's just the name I give it. And then what I can do here, I can say condition. Okay, so you can either also use any of these things. So I could, for example, check the email address from the sender, something like that, right? The date, the subject, and so on. But I can also use a bunch of native modules in here. So here I have general functions. Now it's a little bit taggy. I'll leave this for another tutorial. Here also math functions, text and binary functions, and then here date. So what I could do here, I could say here format date, and then here I say now. And then I format it to DDDD. So that means weekday and then equal to Saturday or then I copy this, I paste this and I say equal to Sunday and I click OK. And then over here, then I would save it. So from this moment on, every 15 minutes, it's going to check my inbox. And then if it's weekend, so if the current day of the week is equal to Saturday, or Sunday, it will continue and it will send an email back. So this is just a super simple example. I'm also not really using this in my business, but I just wanted to show you how these modules work. But then if you want to, you can like build it out. You can add another module, filters in between, super handy. But so what I wanna do is I wanna show you some actual examples that I'm using in my business to give you some inspiration of what you could use Integromat for. So then we go over to scenarios. Then let's see what I can show you. For example, this one here, validate new leads. So whenever someone is joining my email list inside ActiveCampaign, I want to make sure this is really a real person and not like some fake email address, a disposable email address, or that somebody made like a typo inside their email address. So what I do here, I have a module. So this is a webhook. And this webhook basically is like a link. I have this inside ActiveCampaign, inside an automation. It will start whenever somebody is joining any list there. So then this will instantly trigger. You can see that here. So we have here runs immediately. So it's not like a schedule. And then over here, I, for example, check if the contact's email address is not me, because I do lots of testing. I want to exclude myself. And then we go to never bounce. So I use never bounce. To validate my email addresses. So it's just like a service. You give them your email address or an email address and they will tell you if it's real or not. So here we insert the email address and then it's going to give a result back. So I could, for example, also say here, give this email address, run this module only, and then you can also test it. And then you see here that the result is valid because this was one of my email addresses. But so that's super handy, I think. So here, then you also see what things it checks. Then we go over here to the router because I have two different results. Either we have a success or we have an error. So if there's an error, so here you see the fallback route, Then I'm going to update a context custom field value. So then here the email validation field inside ActiveCampaign, I will set to error for the contact. And then here you have the contact ID from the first module that I got from ActiveCampaign. And here, if it's a success, so this module was a success, then the result I get from this is here. It's either valid, it's invalid, it's catch-all, it's disposable, or it's unknown. And then what I do over here, I set the email validation field to that result. Here, the context ID again, so that ActiveCampaign also knows like, hey, whose custom field do you want to update? And then here I have a filter. So then you see here, if the result is equal to invalid or the result is equal to disposable, then I want to unsubscribe those people from my list, right? Because it's not a real email address. So then here in the next module, I say update the contacts list status. So here you see that I'm connected to ActiveCampaign. Then which list do you want to update them to? And then here is a contact ID so that again, ActiveCampaign knows like, hey, who is this person? And then status unsubscribed. So whenever somebody is joining my list, this webhook will start. Never bounce is checking, is this a real email address? And then if this went right, we should have a success. And then I store the result inside a custom field inside ActiveCampaign. So that also in ActiveCampaign, I know like, hey, is this a real email address or not? And then if it's invalid or disposable, then I unsubscribe them from the list. And if for something, for some reason, something went wrong, then we have here a fallback route. And then we just update that custom field with error so that I know like, hey, something went wrong over there. But it doesn't necessarily mean that this is an invalid or disposable email address. So it's just like a fallback route. So yeah, this is one of the use cases that I'm using. I really love this because this way I just keep like a clean email list. Then I'm going back to my scenarios. Then another one that I want to show you is my reply parser. And this is maybe all really techy, but I just want to nerd out in this a bit and show you some cool examples of what I'm doing. But you can also just create really simple, handy integrations, right? So here you see that I have a mail hook. And what this basically does is that whenever somebody is replying to one of my emails that I'm sending with ActiveCampaign, then it goes to my inbox so that I just see the replies. But also this scenario will start whenever I get an email that was replied to. Then I'm going to search for that contact with the ActiveCampaign module. And then we have a router because I have a bunch of different paths. So for example, I send people one email and that email is called falling out of love. So this is something I send to people whenever I see like, hey, this person is not opening emails. And then I ask them like, hey, I'm going to unsubscribe you in a few days if you don't reply to this email. So please reply now with a certain word, like I'm engaged or something. And then if they reply, then this will start. They follow this route. And then we resubscribe that person to the list. And then I'm also creating an event inside ActiveCampaign. Now, then I also have a bunch of different ones here. For example, here I have a Gmail module. So I have an email called onboarding new subscribers. So I tell people like, hey, this is how you should onboard new subscribers. And then I say, PS, if you would like the exact automation that I'm using to onboard my subscribers, then just reply with template and then they reply. So then this scenario starts, search for the contact, then they follow this filter. The filter here, you see the subject contains onboarding new subscribers. And then here in the Gmail module, I say here, okay, this email is from me to the person that sent me the reply. Then we have the subject, and then over here we have the whole email. So I wrote this in HTML, you don't have to do that, but this way it just matches my branding a little bit more. So I start with like, Hey, thanks for replying. You can import the onboarding flow over here. Then I have my signature. PS, let me know if you have any questions about it. So this is super cool and I got so many awesome replies in this from people that's like, hey, how are you doing this? Or actually people that maybe also thought that I'm doing this by hand because I send it by Gmail. So you can also not really see that it is automated. So yeah, I think this is pretty cool. So this is another example of what you could do with it. Then maybe another example that I could show you here. I think this, for example, is also super handy. So here I have Calendly. So I'm using Calendly so that people can pick a spot in my calendar and then they can just book a call with me. And I do all these calls with Zoom. And What I first was doing is that somebody was like booking that call and I got a notification and then I had to create that call in Zoom and send people the link. But now with Calendly, it's super handy. They already create the Zoom call for you. So they basically schedule that, but I still had to send people the link. So I thought, how handy would it be if I could create a scenario that will start whenever there's a new scheduled event. So somebody's booking like a coaching call with me, something like that. Then here, valid event, I have some filters in there. And then I send a confirmation email to that person with the Zoom link. So you can see over here that the email comes from me. Then I send it to the invitee, so the people that used Calendly to subscribe or not subscribe to like schedule a call with me, right? Then I have the subject, details about our call. And then here I just say like, hey, first name, thanks for booking a call with me. You can join the, now this is like a little bit techie, but I basically say here, you can join the 21st of January at this time with this link. And then I have the Zoom link over here so that I don't have to do anything. I only have to show up in Zoom. Then here I'm going to search for the contact. And then here is okay, the contact was actually found, because sometimes people also can book calls with me if they're not an active campaign, right? So then I want to stop it if the contacts do not exist inside ActiveCampaign. And then I just add a note to their profile that says like, hey, first name. So John just scheduled a call with Calendly, event name, duration. So they can just see that in the contacts profile. Now, then I wanna show you another one. So yeah, as you can see, probably there's really so much possible with this. And I'm also really genuinely excited about this because there's just so much possible. Now, then here, for example, another one that's maybe cool, free group members. So I have a group on Facebook, and when people join that group, you can ask a few questions to those people. So I, for example, ask like, hey, what do you hope to get out of this group? And would you like to receive my best tips by email? If yes, enter your email address. And then when they type their email address, I automatically want to add them to my email list inside ActiveCampaign. So unfortunately, I cannot 100% automate this, but first I was copying the email address, copying their name, putting it manually inside ActiveCampaign was a bit of a pain in the ass. And now I can add the people to a spreadsheet, so inside Google Sheets, and then whenever there is a new row in this spreadsheet, this scenario will start. Then it's also going to check, okay, the email address row exists, the full name row exists, and another row also exists. I forgot what this was about. I think it's like the question they answered. And then I say, okay, list contacts. And then I'm basically checking, does this person already exist or does not exist? And then if they don't exist, then I create a new contact. I add a note, I add a tag. And then I, for example, here check, okay, what are they interested in based on the answer that they give? And then I add a tag to the contact. So for example, here, if they're interested in ManyChat, I add a tag that says interested in ManyChat. And then also in this case, set which bot builder they are using. But so yeah, these are just some use cases that I'm using. I absolutely love Integromat. I think it's so cool what you can do with it. And I'm using, I think, maybe 15 or 16 marketing automation tools that I'm paying a subscription fee to on a monthly basis. And Integromat by far is the cheapest of them all. Well, I think I maybe get the most value out of it. So again, if you want to check Integromat out, you can use the link in the description below. Then I get a little kickback from that. And if you have any questions about Integromat or you want to see some examples, then just drop a comment in the comments below and then I'll try to get back to you there.